Hi, I'm Duncan Jones from digital marketing agency Web Profits, and I'm a recovering Google AI optimization skeptic. Today I'll go through why I used to be a skeptic, what's changed, and I'll give you a breakdown on all of the options available for you to test. I used to be a vocal skeptic of all of the AI and machine learning settings in Google AdWords, and against our Google team's regular suggestions, we resisted switching any campaigns over. Why? Well, quite simply, we'd tested these settings multiple times for clients over the past 6 or 7 years, and it didn't work. We'd switch them on for a client who had consistent and improving results, and then we'd wait. Results either declined, went haywire, or it ramped up the spend to Google's benefit, but without any additional conversions. So what's changed? Well, firstly, AdWords campaigns have become more and more complex, and there's now so many ways you can adjust your cost per click bids based on a user's location, the device they're on, time, and heaps more variables. And it's now becoming near impossible to accurately set these bids for all of the variables manually. Secondly, Google have improved its AI and machine learning to the point where they are actually making a positive impact to campaigns. And as we retested these bidding settings slowly, over time, they actually started to work. These two factors piqued our interest, so we roped in an AI expert from Google to come in and present to our team. Since then, we've worked out the best way to use these settings and have been rolling out and testing AI across all eligible campaigns, and results have been pretty promising. Before I take you through the options though, there are a few things you need to do to get the best results. Firstly, double check all conversions are being tracked correctly, and that each conversion is valuable for your business and will actually have an impact on your growth. Google will optimize based on the data that you give them, so you need to make sure that you're only counting things that matter. Secondly, ensure you have built a best practice campaign which has segmented ad groups, awesome ads and offers, relevant keywords in the right match type, extensions in place, and all other common elements in high converting campaigns. Thirdly, Google needs a lot of data to learn how to set its bids, so the more you have, the better the results will be. You should definitely wait until your campaigns have been running for at least 2 months, and until you're generating over 30 conversions per month before you test these bidding settings. If you meet those three requirements and you're ready to move your campaigns over to Google's AI bidding, there are a few different options that you can test. Which one you should try depends on the type of campaign you're running. The most commonly used are enhanced cost per click, which will automatically adjust your bid up and down depending on if a conversion is likely or unlikely. Maximize conversions, which will automatically set your bids to get as many conversions as possible within your campaign's budget, but without caring about the cost per conversion. Target cost per acquisition, which will automatically set your bids to get as many conversions as possible within your CPA goal, but with no target on the volume of conversions. And target return on ad spend, which will automatically set bids to generate as much e-commerce revenue as possible within your target. Each of those options will give you a recommended bid, be it a bid per conversion or a return on ad spend amount. I would start with Google's recommendation at first, as if you bid too low or too high, your campaigns won't work effectively. There are a few other automated bidding settings that I'd be a bit careful with and would only apply for very specific campaigns if you know what you're doing. They are target search page location, which will automatically target your ad to the top of the search results or onto the first page. Target outranking share, which will let you automatically outbid and appear above a selected competitor's ads. And maximize clicks, which will automatically get you the most clicks possible out of a certain budget. Whatever AI bidding option you select for your campaigns, make sure you're patient, which I know is really, really tough with digital marketing. The campaigns will need time to learn and for the AI to test new bids, so I'd give it at least 2 months before you change anything, because every bid or budget change you make during this time will reset the learning period. If you have a campaign that's already working and you're scared to test automation, you should take a look into bidding experiments, where you can test a new bidding strategy on just 50% of the campaign, but it will take longer to get results. Since I'm still a recovering skeptic, I'll point out the one concern I have before I finish up, and that's the power that Google is going to have if everyone has automation turned on. With a flick of a switch, they could increase every cost per click on every keyword, reaping themselves billions, without too many advertisers even noticing. That's a lot of power to wield, and I do hope they use it wisely. Despite this, these bidding options are working, so advertisers should definitely move ahead with testing and implementation. If there's any other skeptics or converts out there, I'd love to hear how these settings are going for you in the comments. That's it for now. Thanks for watching.